Oppy was hiding a magic teleporter? We could have been beaming all over the zone this whole time?
Don't worry. I'll restore her connection once you do us a little favor. We suspect Oppy's hiding a copy of ARDA's database in that auto shop of hers. Find it, and we can get back to this remnant business.
All right, I've identified the electrical circuit for the garage's security system.
And there's an ARDA security lock in that circuit. So once I do this... Bingo! That security lock's powered on now. Try that overload code from the observation towers. 4735.
Driver, something you should know about that database? When ARDA's funding began to dry up, they handed us our final paycheck with one hand and the same day evacuation orders with the other. Oppy was a higher up, though more entitled than an actual power by that time. She would have known about ARDA's plan to close up shop and had enough time to download all the research data before losing access. That data could contain what we need to help you.
Vault? I bet there's some good stuff in there. Oh, you did it! Hey, you actually did it! Oh, boy, howdy, I cannot wait to dig through all this data. As promised, I'll fix Oppy's connection.
Do you read me? Come in, do you read me?
Loud and clear, you old bat.
I see. The comms clear up suddenly, and I find you two patched to the garage frequency. It all makes sense now.
No idea what you're talking about. So, Oppy, what's the plan? You must have some grand scheme, don't you?
Let me get this straight. You hijacked my mission, tapped into my frequency, and now you want to be all buddy-buddy. Not on your life. You think you're hot stuff. Why don't you take the lead, then? Get the driver through all by your damn selves.
Did she just hang up on us? Well, guess it's our time to shine. So, Francis, you got any ideas?
Well, we know the driver needs to get to the deep zone, but it's too dangerous to head there directly. We have to zero in on exactly where to go. The signal amplification trick won't work here. The ambient instability is too strong in the mid-zone.
Huh, how indeed. There was one other time where the mass hallucination and the remnants intersected. Driver, I've tagged a route for you. Whenever you're ready, give it a spin.
Driver, sorry about all that mess with Oppy. There's no question, Oppy is a once-in-a-generation genius. I've watched her manipulate wavelengths with nanometer precision without batting an eye.
So, yeah, to see her go from being the sharpest person in the room to what she is now is...
disappointing. This place, it leeches away your sanity day by day. So for Oppy to live here in complete isolation, locked away with only bad memories and expired medication?
Nothing good comes of that.
I'd feel a hell of a lot better if I knew why she suddenly cares so much about the remnants.
Speaking of Oppy, you're not gonna like this, Francis, but I'm starting to think we can't do this alone.
Look,
it's not that I doubt our abilities, but no one knows the zone like that old bat.
You heard what she said. She'll sabotage this remnant before helping us.
Right. Well, She'll come around to our charms.
No, she won't. Nothing in the 13 years we spent in R&D proved that she's open to working with anyone. She dug her heels in so deep that she wrestled everyone down into the grave with her. I can't be involved if she is.
What are you talking about? This is the entire reason we stayed behind, to write the record of the Zone.
Not about the experiments and the technology, but to tell the legends of the land.
I don't want anything to do with her. I don't want to talk to her. I don't want her advice. I don't want to hear her goddamn voice.
This isn't like you. What's going on, Francis? Is there something I should know?
No.
All your work in Lim R&D, all the time you spent, your entire career, your entire life, you sacrificed it all for ARDA, and how did they thank you? With a black hole in your resume, where you can't tell anyone what you did. You couldn't even tell people where you wiped your ass for 10 years.
So no, I'm not letting this go. Not for me, but especially not for you.
That's not... Never mind.
You know, sometimes I wonder,
how much of you staying here was actually to hunt these legends? Or if it was because you had nowhere else to go?
Here's what we know. Over 50 years ago, in November of 1946, Dr. Ophelia Turner was 27. She had recently returned home to the Olympic Peninsula to lick her wounds after a failed stint in academia. In a fit of obsession or redemption, or quite frankly, both, she cobbled together a laboratory in her basement and produced the first limb wave on nothing but a killer hunch and plain ingenuity.
Or so the story goes. It's never clearly stated anywhere what limb waves and limb technology really were. It's all vague claims and wild theories, dreams that border more on the mystical than the scientific. What we do know is that LIM stood for unlimited frequency. Radio waves, once souped up and modulated just right, supposedly enabled the control of matter in a way that modern science both back then and now could only dream of. After Dr. Turner's discovery, she and a few friends, scientists and PhDs all, toyed with LIM in their garage labs for about 4 years. The local police and fire departments start making regular house calls, spurred on by increasingly disgruntled neighbors calling in about incidents that seem to grow larger and more disturbing as the years go on. After one too many reports, the federal government takes notice, and thus begins their severe interest in limb technology. The next part happens quickly. In 1955, the United States government seizes not only the physical area where Dr. Turner and her scientists live, but the entire concept of limb technology. The area is at first evacuated under the pretense of safety, but quickly commandeered by the government. They establish a brand new department called ARDA, Advanced Resonance Development Authority, which was to be headed by Dr. Turner herself. Over the next 15 years, the government expands the zone's borders. They clear out civilians as they go and erect massive 500-meter walls to keep out an increasingly curious public. The zone started in the northernmost tip of the peninsula, then expanded outward twice, once in 1961, again in 1967, to the outer perimeter we see now.
Thank you.
Are you ready, driver? Okay, first off, I've loaded up three locations on your ARC device map. You see them? Head to whichever strikes your fancy.
You're sending them to the visions?
Sure am. We're gonna use this.
My optical vasilizer. We shouldn't use that.
Why not?
I mean, it's been decades. No way that thing is in any sort of working shape.
I've been fixing it up in secret, and I'm sorry. Don't be mad. It's gonna be a surprise for your birthday. Oh, I've gone ahead and made an itty-bitty modification to your headset, driver. I've hooked up the basilizer here to modulate your scan function. Think of it like an extra layer of mayonnaise on your technology sandwich.
What are you using the basilizer for?
No spoilers. We have to tell the story from the beginning. Driver, get ready to feast your eyes on the visions. I told you about the mass hallucination. Hundreds of people, 30 seconds of crazy, yada yada. But there was one instance where that event and the remnants intersected. The story of Laura Cesari. Laura worked at ARDA as an executive secretary. She put in her hours, but she spent her evenings with a real passion. Painting. When the hallucination event swept through, Laura was overtaken like everyone else. But for her, the visions didn't stop. She tried painting them, but grew frustrated at her inability to recreate what she saw. Now at first, Otto wrote her off as one of the many whose brains got scrambled by what they saw. Until Laura stumbled across a rusty can of paint in the woods. It was a remnant. Once she started using this paint, the visions in her paintings began to come true. She painted feverishly for over a year, chasing the visions the entire time. Until the day the paint ran empty.
And then she disappeared. Like all remnant holders do.
Now that we know the remnants and the mass hallucination are related, maybe Laura's visions can help us out.
where your theory comes in, Francis. You tell him. Look at me, man. By the way, Francis, you explain it. It's so good.
No, it's just I'd rather not.
Come on, we talked about this. You should be proud of your work. Toot your own horn.
Not this time.
Okay. Well, Francis' theory, his entire branch of research was that the zone exhibits a property seen nowhere else on Earth. Every phenomenon that occurs here leaves its fingerprint forever on the physical space. So he created this device to pick up on these sub-physical after effects. How did you explain it? It was like identifying a whale's favorite color using only the wake it leaves behind. The rest was science mumbo-jumbo.
It's a form of electromagnetic imprint. Anyway, it was a long time ago.
And what a better time than now to try it again.
great Pileup. You know, if you catch the mural at the right angle, when the moon is right overhead, you can spot the helmsman's body in one of the boats.
No chance. It's a paint smudge, nothing more.
Believe me, it's true. I've seen it.
Hey, is it just me, or did this mural look different before?
Probably the instability messing with the paint over time. It's been decades, after all.
Nah, something's definitely off. Hey, where's our old notes from when we took a field trip out that way? Driver, why don't you go ahead to the next one while we investigate this?
No, I'm telling you, the helmsman never made it out of the zone. He died here.
Not this again. I still don't know why you're so convinced he existed in the first place.
Driver, back me up here. This is how the story goes. It was the winter of 72. A ship set sail down the Columbia River 100 miles east of here. The helmsman was overcome by bad weather, and while in a particularly foggy patch, the boat hit something, and the impact threw him from the deck. When he woke up, he was on a boat on this very lake, smack in the middle of the zone, with no idea how he got there.
He had with him a ridiculous amount of cash and paid anyone and everyone to get him out of the zone. But no matter how he tried to leave, on foot, in a transport, he would always head into a fog and reemerge on another boat. At last count, the Great Pileup was 20 boats high and 30 boats wide.
A limb duplication glitch, nothing more.
And you, of all people, blaming limb tech instead of a good old-fashioned mystery?
It doesn't add up. Artist's favorite pastime was carting people out of the zone. How could someone actually fail to escape? And a mysterious man with a backpack full of cash, and the one place he can't spend it, seems awfully fishy to me.
10-foot mural. My personal favorite. What did you see there, Francis? Oh boy, Francis, look. Look here. It's different from our sketch when we visited in 82.
It's all scrambled, but the shape seems familiar. If you tilt your head, doesn't that kind of look like Mount Olympus?
Oh, Francis, you flippin' genius! It absolutely is! Wait, let's look back at the first one. What's different there?
That shape right there, is that Hook Valley?
Holy smokes! Wait, pull up all the topographical maps of the peninsula. If we look around the areas where you'd get that view of Mount Olympus... See, Francis? I told you your basilizer would work!
I don't think this is the basilizer's to...
Driver, we're on to something. Get to that third vision.
Driver, if you come across a mushroom like the one in the mural, do not eat it. No matter how tasty it might look.
You're speaking from personal experience. And let me tell you, it wasn't pretty.
Oh, just thinking about it makes me want to puke
all over again. You've probably passed the biogenerators by now. They're our source of power in the mid-zone, and one of the best demonstrations of renewable limb tech. Yes, these battery farms keep our lights on, but more importantly, they're also the only place in the entire zone where anomalized mushrooms grow.
And guess who turned out to be the world's biggest fan of those mushrooms? Bigfoot itself! And the vision foretold its arrival in the zone!
It started when those pods hanging from the battery farms were found chewed up. At first, they blamed it on the local wildlife. This was back when we used to have some. Then, the sightings of 10-foot-tall creatures started that didn't attract much attention on their own.
Not until the first footprints were found. The Olympic Peninsula has always had a collection of Bigfoot sightings. But they were rare until Bigfoot had its first taste of the anomalized mushrooms.
Then it couldn't stay away. And that's when the Squatches came knocking. They jumped the wall, set up camp, and they got to investigate it. Once they learned of the Sasquatch's appetite for these mushrooms, they cultivated entire farms of the stuff.
For months, they propagated mushrooms and set traps. And for months, evidence mounted that Sasquatch was making its rounds and evading those traps. Until one night, the experts disappeared.
Bigfoot got them. No question.
Come on, all 8 at once? How is that possible?
Never get in the way of a hungry Sasquatch. So about that last vision.
I can't even look at it. Francis, you explain it.
And maybe you've already seen them, Driver. A freestanding bright blue door in its frame, out in the wilderness with nothing around it. If you do see one, don't get anywhere close to it.
I don't want to talk about it.
He was pretty close to a doorway when it opened. It's called the inverting doorway. When the door is shut, it's safe. But once in a while, it opens, and everything near it is turned inside out. Its victims are mostly bears, squirrels, and birds. They all go through hell. Meat and bones on the outside, fur and feathers on the inside. It's not fun to see. Once, a group of hikers didn't heed the warning, and...
No, we're done here, Driver. If you see one, you stay away from it. That's all you need to know. Let's go.
Thank you.
The inverting doorway.
I don't like this one. Oh, bingo!
See that pattern in the last mural? That flower only grows above a certain elevation. Put the three locations together, and you've got a square mile in the northeast corner of the deep zone. Huh. The visions were pointing towards something the entire time.
Hey, Oppy. You can stop pretending to ignore us now.
Take a look at this fine work. We've pinned down the location for the source of the mass hallucination. That's where the driver needs to go.
Well, what do you know?
Well, I knew the basilizer worked. What did I tell you, huh?
He still doesn't know, Francis.
Know what? Oppy?
Not my story to share.
My theory. And that basilizer, they're, illegitimate.
Wait, what are you saying?
I built that device to prove my imprint theory, and it was on the verge of getting the results I needed. But my research funding was running out. So, I forged the data. Not much, just enough to justify more time. I was so close. I knew the breakthrough was right around the corner. But ARDA found out. That's why I was reassigned and my clearance revoked.
Wait, you told me you changed labs voluntarily.
8 years of research with nothing to show for it. And then for that to happen, I couldn't face you.
That doesn't mean your theory is wrong. I still think there's something to it. There's a common thread with some of the remnant stories, like the telephone switchboard, the ones that seem to recall the past somehow. Maybe the remnants access those imprints, read them like a needle in the groove of a record.
Don't. You don't have to do that. It's in the past. I don't care about it anymore.
But listen, I've got this suspicion, right? If we can just get the car to the mass hallucination source, what do we find that can prove your theory? It's worth a try, isn't it?
I'm tired of trying, Tobias. I've tried all my life, and it didn't go so well.
Look, I don't have one of those fancy degrees that you and Oppy have. The closest I ever got to science was wiping down your lab benches. But I saw the incredible things that you did with your research.
Yeah, well, ARDA didn't think they were incredible.
I don't care about ARDA.
I believe in you. Always have.
I'm sorry. I can't. I can't do this with her.
Oppy led the disciplinary committee that stripped my clearance and demoted me to a glorified intern. She sat there and decided how best to humiliate me. I never asked for anything. This one time I do, so I would never have to talk to Oppy again. You didn't listen. Your remnant was more important than what I wanted.
Francis, I didn't mean...
I've had enough.
He'll come around. Sorry, we'll see you back at the auto shop.
interesting thing about that deep zone area you identified. I ran every coordinate in that area through the ARDA database, and what turns up? But access logs, with entry records for Dr. K up through March 1963.
What?
No, the doctor died in 1961.
And in the lab accident.
So we were told. Then, I found access logs for both that deep zone site and Red Meadow. Years and years worth of activity.
The Red Meadow Research Facility? But it was demolished the same year. After the structural damage caused by the... lied about that too, didn't they?
It appears so. The driver should give the Red Meadow ruins a visit. If Dr. K didn't die that day, I'd like to know what was keeping him so busy.
So would I, but... do we have time for this? We don't know how long the driver's got with that remnant.
And that's why we need this information. Whatever Dr. K was doing relates to all of this. It may be the key to what lies at the end of the road for the driver.
I agree with you. God, I hate saying that.
Driver, I've marked the Red Meadow facility on your route planner. Head there whenever you're ready. You won't survive long out there. Not with the way you're driving. But I've got an old experimental device in the garage that might help.